Okay, in today's lecture, let us see a couple of applications of matrices, how matrices will help us in solving problems. First is Fibonacci sequence. First, 0 and 1. And then every neighbor is found out by using a simple formula. A of n plus 1 is equal to A of n minus 1 plus a. Okay. Now next term is sum of the previous two terms. Now we are supposed to introduce matrices in this game. And hence we do it like this. A n is equal to 0 times an minus 1 plus a. So these are the two simultaneous equations that we have. 1, 1, 1. And therefore, our vector equation, I mean a matrix equation, will look like this. An n plus 1. This is resultant vector, which is 0, 1, 1, 1 matrix times an minus 1 an. Right? So this is our matrix A. And you will observe that this vector an, an plus 1 is one step ahead of an minus 1 an. So matrix A converts vector an minus 1 an into an plus 1. So this is the starting point. You have ax is equal to b expression, and therefore if I want to write an minus 1, I will be able to write 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, which is A, same. And for this, I can use the same recurrence relation. Again, A, 0, 1, 1, 1, and a vector would become an minus 2, an minus 1. This is the whole idea. And hence, if you keep doing it, 0, 1, 1, 1, how many times you have to write so that eventually you write the last vector 0, 1, which is our these two terms. And n. Is this correct? Please cross check. When an minus, I mean the suffix n minus suffix n minus 1 was there, the power was 1. Suffix n minus 2, power is 2. Suffix 0, n, we will consider this term as 0th term. This is first, second, third, something like that. So this is correct. So plus n. And therefore, our expression which we are supposed to solve to get value of an and an plus 1 is matrix A raised to n. A raised to n we need to find out. Okay. And we have what methods to raise the power of any matrix, and which is if we can express A as S lambda S inverse, raising power A raised to n is not difficult. It is S lambda raised to n S inverse. So find eigenvalues and vectors of Okay, so if you create a minus lambda I and make it equal to zero, determinant of that, you get the characteristic equation as lambda square minus lambda minus one is equal to zero, whose roots are 1 plus root 5 upon 2. We will call positive root as lambda one and negative root as lambda two. So these are the two real eigenvalues for this matrix. We were expecting real because this is a symmetric and real matrix A. So eigenvectors are also expected to be perpendicular. So next question is, find eigenvectors. And the trick that I will show you is, you find eigenvectors in terms of lambda 1 and lambda 2. Lambda 1 and lambda 2. So every time you need not have to write down this bad number. We will substitute this bad number in the end, in our last calculation. Otherwise we will use lambda 1 and lambda 2 as that number. So show me your eigenvectors. Now procedure of finding out eigenvectors. So minus lambda 1, if you put first entry minus lambda 1, 1, 1, 1 minus lambda 1. This is the matrix. You get A minus lambda 1 I multiply by your eigenvector should make it 0, 0. So in what proportion you should add first vector to second? Normally, orally you can do this. You take this one times, and you take this lambda 1 times, you get first row 0, second row will be, suppose I write 1 here and lambda 1 here, you get 1 plus lambda 1 minus lambda 1 square, which is equal to 0. So this is the first eigenvector for lambda 1. Yes. Correct. And now what is the relation between lambda 1 and lambda 2? Product of the roots is minus 1. So lambda 2 is 1 upon lambda 1. Correct. So your matrix is plus 1 upon lambda 1, 1, 1, 1 plus 1 upon lambda 1. And you do some calculations and you will realize that your matrix lambda 1 minus 1 will also work. Lambda 1 times first vector and minus 1 times second vector. Lambda 1 times first vector is plus 1 in the first place, minus 1, 0. Lambda 1 minus 1, minus 1 upon lambda 1 is also going to be 0. Okay, so two eigenvectors that you get, or what is your S now? S is 1 upon 1 lambda 1, lambda 1 minus 1. This is your S. Now let us cross check whether our these two vectors which we have got are orthogonal or not, because we wanted them to be perpendicular because A is symmetric matrix. So lambda 1 into 1 is lambda 1 minus lambda 1 into 1 is minus lambda 1 is equal to 0. So these two vectors, eigenvectors, are perpendicular. So this is your S, correct? So almost we are done now. We have S with us. We have, so S inverse is going to be, it is 2 by 2. Therefore it is easy. You replace, change the positions of the diagonal and add minus sign to remain. Is this the inverse? Check, or you need to divide by something. What is the S inverse? Divide by determinant of this, which is minus 1 minus lambda square. So this is 1 upon minus 1 minus lambda square, and minus is there everywhere. So if you multiply by minus 1, so S inverse comes out to be, one upon lambda 1 square plus 1, that is the determinant, inside bracket 1 lambda 1 lambda 1 minus 1. This is the inverse. Okay, so if that is the inverse, then we have the equation, our original equation. An plus 1 is equal to S, which is 1 lambda 1 lambda minus 1 into H. Eigen values lambda 1 0 0, lambda 2 is minus 1 upon lambda 1 raised to n into S inverse which is, you can take this constant out, 1 upon lambda 1 square plus 1, and your inverse is 1 lambda 1 lambda 1 minus 1 multiplied by 0 1. Okay, so this is what is going to give you. Now let us simplify it further and really write down. Now we don't need an and an plus 1. We don't need an and an plus 1 both. We need only an. Suppose 10th term you are supposed to find out. Then 8n you want. You don't want 8n and 11 simultaneously. Okay. So for that, what trick we should use as far as matrix multiplication is concerned, that if you want only an, you pre-multiply it by 1 comma 0. An plus 1. What will be the product? Product of this is going to be 1 times an, 0 times n plus 1. So you get, which is equal to 1 upon lambda 1 square plus 1 into 1 comma 0 times 1 lambda 1 lambda 1 minus 1. Now we can take that power inside, lambda 1 raised to n 0 0 minus 1 raised to n upon lambda 1 raised to n, and then 0 1. So we are left with some simplification of this. Sorry, inverse laser, 1 lambda 1 minus 1 0 1. So can you get me the final formula in terms of lambda 1 for an? Let me leave some space so that I will be able to do these calculations. And what is an? Get me the final formula. And lambda 1 is known to us. The moment we come to know what is n, we should be able to find out the Fibonacci number. Okay, after multiplication of these five, you will end up getting an is equal to lambda 1 raised to n plus 1 plus minus 1 upon lambda 1 raised to n minus 1 whole divided by, now lambda, see this is lambda 2 actually, minus 1 upon lambda 1 is lambda 2 upon lambda 1 square plus 1. Okay, and if you have n value which is very large, then the second term also is going to disappear, but let it be right now. So we know lambda 1 is equal to 1 plus root 5 upon 2. Let n is equal to 10. Find an. Even if this expression is such a bad expression, even if the value of lambda 1 is irrational, eventually an that you will get is going to be positive integer. Find a 10. Okay, similar working and similar thinking can be used for recurrence relation problems. You should be able to only the most difficult part in this entire setup is to get the matrix equation in place. The first step itself is the most difficult. This step, writing two equations in this matrix form, vector form. So once you are done with that, then eigenvalues, eigenvectors are going to help you out in dealing with the remaining thing. Okay, let us look at one more problem. Suppose now we have application number 2. Suppose we have a degree 2 equation in x and y. Okay, and now we want to use matrices to solve degree 2 equation. So look at the arrangements that are being done. If we look at the homogeneous part of this degree 2 equation, then we write it like this. Again, this is symmetric matrix, and if we multiply it by a vector x comma y, what do we get? Ax plus b by 2y, b by 2x cy. That is not sufficient. Homogeneous part is to be made where you need x square, and therefore we take x, y transpose. Suppose this is my vector capital X, then this is x transpose, and this is my vector A. Okay, so now if I multiply these three guys, what will I get? Let me do it in two steps. This is x, y, and this one 2 by 1, 2 by 2 into 2 by 1 is 2 by 1, ax plus by 2. Bx by 2 plus cy. Now if I multiply these two, I get row into column, ax square plus bxy by 2, correct, row plus bxy by 2 plus, this is what I have written, cy square. Okay, so this is your quadratic part, quadratic in the sense homogeneous part. of the equation plus dE times xy plus f is the matrix way of writing degree 2 equation. Check whether you have understood. The matrix way of writing the degree 2 equation, let me write it again, is x comma y a v by 2 b c x comma y d comma e times x comma y plus f is equal to ax square plus bxy plus cy square plus dx plus ey plus f. Okay, so we have learned while learning the conic sections that we need rotation. We need rotation to get rid of xy term. And if you remember correctly, it is x is equal to x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta, and y is equal to x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta was our rotation transformation. Now, having learned the matrices, we can always write this equation as x comma y is equal to cos theta minus sin theta cos theta times x dash comma y dash. Okay. If this was our capital X vector here, then this is going to be our transformation matrix P, what we discussed yesterday. This is our P. This is our new system. After rotation, X dash Y dash becomes capital new system. So X is equal to P times capital X dash. This was the equation which we have used yesterday in change of base. So basically you are changing the base, you are creating a rotation of the system, and your matrix P is cos theta sine theta minus sine theta cos theta. Now, if you observe this P again, if theta is a real number, then it is a real matrix. And it's not symmetric, but it is skew symmetric. Okay, let it be. But every vector is a normal vector. Cos square plus sine square is equal to 1. Sine square plus cos square is equal to 1. And what is the determinant of this matrix? Again, cos square plus sine square is equal to 1. So sine square 1. Okay. So these are the properties of this vector P, that it is all the vectors are having length equal to 1. Okay, and determinant of this matrix is also equal to 1. This is orthogonal also. These vectors are orthogonal because take dot product of these two column vectors, cos theta minus sine theta, it is 0. Minus of cos theta sine theta, this is plus of cos theta. So these vectors are perpendicular. Suppose let me write down vector v1 is cos theta sine theta, and v2 is minus sine theta cos theta they are given with perpendicular to V2, so they are orthonormal. This is a orthonormal matrix, orthogonal, but because the length of each vector is 1, it is orthonormal matrix. So it is a very good matrix for a transformation. They are perpendicular vectors. Now, the equation that we have here is, what is this equation? This is X transpose A X. Is that correct? This is the quantity which we need to deal with. And this is just some vector, some DE comma X multiplied by X plus F. Okay. And this term is important because that term involves XY term. This first term, X transpose AX, has got XY term in it. And now we are using rotation to, we are using rotation transformation to check what should be our degree 2 equation. And we expect that if we do the rotation correctly, we get rid of XY term. Okay. So now, can we find out? Okay. Now, first, let us do this X transpose that we have here. So, X transpose AX is equal to PX dash, which is X transpose, times A PX dash transpose times A times PX dash, correct, which is equal to, now PX dash transpose is X dash transpose times P A X dash X dash transpose times P transpose A P X dash. बघा समजतंय का इथपर्यंत? X dash transpose P transpose A P X dash, and therefore you have X dash transpose P transpose A P X dash. What does this mean? The first term of our homogeneous part, that is X transpose A X, gets converted into X dash transpose multiplied by some matrix X transpose. So what is X dash transpose? X dash transpose will look like X dash into Y dash row matrix multiplied by some matrix. Again, it is going to be 2 by 2 multiplied by X dash comma Y dash. This is what is it is going to look like. And now we are interested in finding out what is this matrix P transpose AP. P transpose A P. Okay, that is where I wait for some time. And can you find out P transpose A P? We have P with us, which is this matrix cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta. We have A with us, which is A B by 2 B by 2 C. Therefore, we should be able to find out P transpose AP and check what surprise do you get. Now, P transpose AP, I am asking you to find out in terms of cos theta sin theta and ABC, which is not good. It should be done maybe for numerical values so that you get the numerical answer and you will be able to cross check. So let me give you an example. 13 x square minus 10 xy plus 13y square minus 72 is equal to 0. Suppose this is the example number 1. Okay. Now you can find out, because the homogeneous part is completely known to you, you can find out what this is, ellipse, hyperbola or parabola. But basically your A value is 13, your B value is minus 5, your B is minus 10, so B by 2 is minus 5, C value is 13. So in this case, find out in this numerical answer, numerical question, your matrix A is 13 minus 5 minus 5, 13. Your P is cos theta minus sin theta, cos theta. Now, one interesting thing that we have noticed yesterday is this is orthonormal matrix. And therefore its inverse is going to be transpose. But then anyway, it is 2 by 2. We would write transpose very easily. Cos theta, minus sin theta, cos theta. This is rotation matrix and its inverse. Now, if you find the product of these three, it is going to be independent of theta. That is what is the surprise element in this. But it is not supposed to be surprised. We were aware that it has to happen like that. Okay, so essentially we need to find out the value of theta for the rotation so that we get rid of xy term. And in this case, that theta will come to 45 degrees. However, let us look at this P transpose AP matrix. Now our P matrix, we have seen that it is orthonormal and its determinant is also 1. Orthonormal means it is anyway orthogonal. Therefore P is orthogonal. Therefore I can write P transpose AP as P inverse AP. Inverse AP, and P is our P inverse AP. So I was going it in the other way direction, but now I have to disclose the answer. Find eigenvalues of A. This is our matrix A. Find eigenvectors of A. Now, again, A happens to be symmetric matrix. We expect its eigenvalues to be real and its eigenvectors to be orthogonal. So that is the good part of this A. And we have created that A to get the degree 2 terms in our quadratic, general degree 2 equation. So it is a symmetry. So find eigenvalues of A, find eigenvectors of A. And then we will go ahead and then we will match these two things that we are trying to do. Eigenvalues happen to be 8 and 18. Okay, so if I consider eigenvalue equal to 8, then it becomes 5 minus 5 minus 5 5, and therefore first eigenvector is 1 1. For 8 it will be 1 1, and for 18 it will be minus 5 minus 5 minus 5 minus 5, therefore eigenvector is going to be minus 1 1 or 1 minus 1. Okay, and therefore our eigen vector matrix S is equal to 1 1 minus 1 1. Our diagonalized matrix lambda is going to be 8 18 0 0. Now we know A into S is equal to S into lambda, capital lambda, and S is our eigen vector matrix. So that is how we factorized A is equal to S lambda S inverse. We did that, we have seen the use of this. Now we do it otherwise. S inverse AS is diagonal matrix, diagonalization. This is the diagonal matrix. However, S is orthogonal matrix. 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, into 1 into 1 is 1, therefore it is 0, therefore these two vectors are orthogonal vectors, and therefore I can write it as S transpose AS is equal to lambda. And now what is S? We can make it orthonormal by dividing by root 2 both sides. So 1 upon root 2 minus 1 upon root 2 1 upon root 2 1 upon root 2. So this is our S normalized, and we can call it as P. Now cos theta is 1 upon root 2 minus sin theta is 1 upon root 2 sin theta is 1 upon root 2. So this P and this P you can correlate now for the value of theta is equal to 45. If theta is equal to 45, S is P, S normalized is P. That is what we get here. And therefore, you are asked to find out P transpose AP, which is P transpose AP, which is going to be P transpose is S, that is S transpose AP, S transpose AP. But S transpose is S inverse AP, AS, sorry, S transpose AS, S inverse AS, and it is bound to be lambda. Therefore, if you take multiplication of 1 upon root 2, 1 upon root 2, minus 1 upon root 2, 1 upon root 2, that is P transpose, multiplied by A, which is 13 minus 5, sorry, say 13, I write 15, 13 minus 5, minus 5, 13, that is your A, and your P, which is 1 upon root 2, minus 1 upon root 2, 1 upon root 2, 1 upon root 2, you are bound to get this value as a product. So that is what is the mystery of eigenvalues and eigenvectors for degree 2 equation. Therefore, once this theory is developed, then the use of this theory is, suppose you have been given degree 2 equation looking like that, 13x square minus 10xy plus 13y square minus 72 is equal to 0, then eventually it will reduce to, directly eventually it will reduce to, in this case. And how do you reduce it? Eventually is, I think we have written it upstairs. Here. Now this X dash transpose TAP X dash. What do we mean by that? X dash transpose TAP into X dash. X dash transpose P transpose AP into X dash. It means X dash is X dash Y dash. AP, now we have just now written it is lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2, and X dash is X dash comma Y dash. So homogeneous part earlier, whatever was given to us, after changing it to X dash Y dash, that means after performing the rotation transformation, it is going to look like this. And if we expand this, we will get, let me keep X dash Y dash as it is, it will be 2 by 2 and this is 2 by 1. So we will get 2 by 1 x, lambda 1 x dash into 0 y dash, 0 x dash lambda 2 y dash. And when you multiply these two, you get this is 1 by 2, this is 2 by 1. Therefore, we will get 1 by 1, which is lambda 1 x dash square plus lambda 2 y dash square. This is what is going to be your quadratic part of the given equation after you perform the rotation transformation. So for all practical purposes, the moment you have been given the quadratic equation, you write the matrix 3 minus 5 minus 5 13. You find out their eigenvalues, find out eigenvalues. They happen to be 8 comma 18. You can directly write the homogeneous part as 8x dash square plus 18 y dash square minus 72 is equal to 0. And therefore, your equation of ellipse is x dash square upon 9 plus y dash square upon 4 is equal to 1. So you go up the rotation part of the axis, which is actually the most difficult or trouble causing part in your problem solving, can be eliminated if you are good at finding out eigenvalues and eigenvectors. I hope you have understood this. Now, from one side we have come, from the other side we have come, and now we are trying to meet in between. Here, S inverse AS is supposed to be diagonalized matrix, lambda. S inverse happens to be S transpose and P transpose are one and the same because eigenvectors happen to be 1, 1, minus 1, 1. Okay. So now there is only one thing which is required to be discussed, which I will just mention, and then I will give you another numerical, which is if you change the order of these eigenvalues, then these eigenvectors also will change. And therefore, now suppose this ellipse was like this now let us have the origin at center because there is no xy term. Suppose ellipse was in this direction and you are performed for say 45 degree. That is how we got this equation. But if you flip, I mean, there are different cases, flexibility is there, different cases you can always do. So here in this diagram, whatever example that we have studied, we have made positive x-axis move in 45 degree, pi by 4 anticlockwise, and hence we got this equation. Okay, so if maybe if you flip them, there will be a variation. If you, I mean, this matrix also can be written in a couple of different ways. Still, it can be considered as orthonormal matrix. Maybe all three of them negative and this positive, or maybe this negative, this positive. So there are more than one ways of writing that particular matrix, keeping it orthonormal. And those are the cases when, number one, case we have already listed here. Number two, case number two, when you are rotating your matrix 235, x-axis 235 degrees. This is 135. In that case, your ellipse after rotation is going to be vertical like this. Okay. Then you can always rotate it through minus 45 degrees. Again, it will look like this. And you can always rotate it through minus 135 degrees. Okay, 45 and minus 35 will give you horizontal ellipse in both the cases, 45 and minus 135. However, minus 45 and plus 135 will give you vertical ellipses. And therefore, you should be ready with whatever eventually you get it. But if we are working with, say, positive angle theta between 0 to 90, then things are going to be relatively easy and you will get the correct picture. However, you find out two values of two eigenvalues and get that equation in place directly. Samajle ka tumhala? Now we have dealt with quadratic term of degree 2 equation. We know how to change it, but then we have dE into xy, which is capital X, and capital X is to be replaced by px dash. So this has to be px dash plus constant is equal to 0. Now what is going to be px dash? It is d comma e into your matrix P, which is cos theta minus sin theta, cos theta times x dash comma y dash. You have to make correct, I mean, not only you are supposed to change here, but you will change here also. But what will happen is you will get rid of xy term and shift of origin is going to be easy for you. Example, 3x square minus 10xy plus 3y square plus 14x minus 2y plus 3 is equal to 0. It is not that you are going to take less time, but I mean, it is good to learn that matrix theory can be used to solve quadratic degree 2 equation in x and y. So now here what we have done is we have found out two eigenvalues. One is minus 2 and plus 8. And corresponding eigenvectors for minus 2 is 1, 1 and 8 minus 1, 1. So because we want our rotation transformation matrix to remain 1, 1 minus 1, 1, we consider minus 2 as first eigenvalue and 8 as second. Therefore, our equation becomes minus 2 x dash square plus 8 y dash square. Then we simplified it in terms of x dash y dash. We get 12 upon root 2 x dash minus 16 upon root 2 y dash plus 3 is equal to 0. And then the work is to be done for shift of origin. After shifting the origin to 3 upon root 2 comma 1 upon root 2, you end up getting the final equation of hyperbola x dash square upon 4 minus y dash square upon 1 is equal to 1. Okay, let us solve one more problem of parabola and see if you can improve your speed a bit. Example number 3. X square minus 4xy plus 4y square minus 6x minus 8y plus 5 is equal to 0. See if you can convert. and get me the standard form of parabola eventually.